Thanks for joining us for another edition of National Focus. I am Lourianne Graham Carter. Coming up, ground broken for over $100 million EC dollars for new hospital, $25 million at aid bank for agriculture and tourism, and Prime Minister calls to recognize outstanding public servants. Stay with us for the details of these and other stories after this.
Think water, think life. Water refreshes, restores, cleans, and enhances growth. Potable water is a benchmark for development. DOASCO is serious about its mandate to ensure easy access to potable water island-wide and provide sewage services for a cleaner environment. DOASCO is your water and sewage company.
Thank you for staying with us. The groundbreaking ceremony of an over $100 million EC dollar state-of-the-art new national hospital at Goodwill on Monday will mean improved healthcare services for Dominicans and visitors in just 2.5 years. The ceremony was attended by the President, His Excellency Charles Savre and Mrs. Savre, Honorable Speaker of the House of Assembly, Alex Boyd Knights, former President of Dominica, His Excellency Lloyd Williams and Mrs. Williams, China's Ambassador to Dominica, His Excellency Li Jiangnin, Honorable Minister for Health and Environment, Dr. Kenneth Daru, other cabinet ministers and other members of the diplomatic corps. The Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt expressed with joy that he has wished for this moment since he first assumed leadership of Dominica.
I wholeheartedly thank and congratulate Ambassador Lee, his technical and negotiating team, and the government and people of the People's Republic of China for ensuring that this pillar project of the 2004 accord between our governments is being honored and delivered upon to the benefit of the citizens of Dominica.
This project is one of the gifts promised by the People's Republic of China under the four-pillar project, which includes the Windsor Park Sports Stadium, the Edward Oliver Leblanc Highway, and rehabilitation of the Dominica Grammar School. Honorable Minister for Health, Dr. Kenneth Daru, called Monday's event a breakthrough moment in the development of Dominica. He stated that the signing of the Memorandum of Understanding began the first step towards an investment that will modernize and revolutionize the delivery of healthcare in Dominica.
High on the priority list of the many plans we presented to you was the commitment to building a new national hospital. And here we are today witnessing the official commencement of this project. Ladies and gentlemen, friends all, just like the postman, we always deliver. And although some said it wouldn't happen, we were never deterred, because this Labour Party administration is always committed to meeting its mandate. And this groundbreaking ceremony here today attests to the seriousness with which we deal with matters of national importance and matters of state.
Construction of the new national hospital is being done by Hunan Construction Engineering Group Corporation from the People's Republic of China. We'll have a full report of Monday's groundbreaking ceremony in tomorrow's newscast. Tuesday, August 9, will be remembered as a very significant day for hoteliers and farmers in Dominica, as government and the Agricultural Industrial Development Bank signed two contracts expected to significantly boost economic activity. Exactly 2 weeks since he outlined in his budget address, Honorable Minister for Finance and Prime Minister Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt signed into agreement the $15 million to improve hotels and restaurants and $10 million to boost the agriculture industry, placing it at the aid bank to on lend to local farmers and hoteliers to improve their businesses. He is confident that the $25 million investment will lead to an increase in jobs for Dominicans.
These two investments by the government no doubt will benefit job creation in our country. There'll be no less than 17 properties which will benefit from the $15 million. And one can understand the construction jobs that will be created. But some of these properties are also expanding and improving their ability or enhancing the ability to compete And once they become competitive, we expect them to do much better than they're doing now, insofar as their businesses and returns are concerned. And therefore, we will see opportunities for more sustainable jobs in the economy and in our country. We understand firsthand the challenges confronting farmers, and we believe by providing that concessionary financing to farmers that they can use to pay the labor, they can use to buy the machinery, they can use to buy the planting material, they will be in a much better position to spend many more hours on the farms and to produce more.
Within this special loan facility, the $10 million to unlend to farmers will be available at a rate of 3% with a six-month grace period, while $15 million will be available to unlend to hoteliers and restaurant owners at a rate of 3% with a one-year grace period. Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt described the terms of the loan agreement as exceptional. The Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Johnson Drago, explained that there are four factors adversely affecting the advancement of farmers: land, labor, knowledge, and capital. The loan facility serves as a direct response to farmers' need for capital, particularly in the pork and poultry sectors.
On a daily basis, several requests are made to the Ministry of Agriculture for financial support by various farmers and other persons wishing to invest in agriculture or agricultural-related activities. Requests range from seeds and planting materials to inputs, waiver of duties on farm vehicles, farm implements, equipment for processing and for value addition, and even packaging materials for export of produce. The Honorable Prime Minister and Minister of Finance have listened. Today, the barrier of limited access to affordable credit and high interest rates will be removed.
The $15 million facility for hoteliers and restaurant owners comes as a result of government's private sector consultation. The Honorable Minister for Tourism, Senator Robert Tong, spoke of his ministry's plans to ensure that beneficiaries of the program are successful.
This loan facility is of much significance to the sector because it further stimulates the enabling environment to allow the private sector to partner in the movement to enhance the experience of our guests and to drive growth in the tourism sector. The government has listened to the requests of the private sector, and we have recognized that such an intervention is required and timely. We are also looking at putting into place what I call a high-level management training course for the hoteliers and for the operators of hotels, because as you're going to be accessing those funds, we want to ensure that your businesses will be successful. So we're going to be working with the Ministry of Commerce, we'll be working with the Aid Bank to ensure that all persons are better equipped to manage the business so that they can be successful.
The two loan facilities are funded by the Citizenship by Investment Program. The Honorable Prime Minister and Minister responsible for the public service, Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, has issued a challenge to administrators to identify and reward top performers in the public service.
Government recognizes that our ability to deliver on all our projects and programs requires the commitment of our public officers to play the part. Government continues to recognize and encourage all public officers who demonstrate a commitment to service. We also want to ensure that those with this level of dedication continue to be rewarded for outstanding performance. To further demonstrate this commitment, government now challenges and mandates the management of the public service to review the performance management system so as to make it more efficient and objective. Once this review is completed, government would consider the introduction of a policy to reward outstanding performance.
He says he has observed the outstanding performance of some exceptional public servants and praises their work. You are watching National Focus. More when we return.
Introducing the Government of Dominica Internal Directory mobile app. Available for download from the Google Play Store, One Mobile Market, and the Government of Dominica's website. Access to all ministries and sub-departments' phone, email and office addresses and websites. Simply select a ministry and the sub-department. You can dial directly from the app or save the numbers to your phone contacts. It's convenience at your fingertips.
Is my passport ready for pickup? Good. It really works.
Download the Government of Dominica Internet Directory mobile app today.
Welcome back. Government has allocated $1 million for the further development of the local music industry in this financial year. This allocation is being funneled through the Ministry of Commerce and Small Enterprise Development. The Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, who is also Finance Minister, made the announcement at the House of Parliament.
Small enterprises play an important part in the national economic and social development of Dominica. As the national economy continues to be more service-oriented, financial, management, and other forms of support must be provided to already established businesses as well as new businesses that are coming on stream. The government has also provided support to small enterprises to improve the quality of the products and services and enhance the level of competitiveness. Particular mention is to be made of $1 million from the allocation to be directed specifically for support to the music industry. Madam Speaker, last fiscal year, the government financed training for musicians and artists in collaboration with the Association of Music Professionals. It is expected that during this year, further training and assistance will be provided.
Last April, government delivered on its promise to provide $500,000 to the Association of Music Professionals for industry development. And finally, All Saints School of Medicine donned white coats to a new group of students over the weekend. This ceremony marked the 28th white coat ceremony of the school. The white coat ceremony traditionally marks the educational milestone of students who have completed 4 semesters of basic sciences. Honorable Minister for Foreign Affairs Francine Barron addressed the ceremony on Saturday.
Today, this white coat ceremony formally marks an educational milestone for the students who have completed 4 semesters of basic sciences and will now transition into the phase of clinical studies of the medicine degree. It is my hope that those of you who are putting on the white coats today are doing so with an understanding that this is a symbol of the commitment that you made to provide comprehensive and compassionate care to your future patients, and to ensure that their best interest is always paramount to the care that you're expected to provide.
All Saints School of Medicine opened its doors here in May 2006 with only 28 students and 12 members of faculty. Today, the school has grown to a student population of 660.
This is indeed a remarkable achievement. We are happy that we have been able to provide a safe and peaceful society in which students can feel comfortable to relax and apply themselves in the pursuit of their dreams, to one day leave our beautiful shores having attained their doctoral degree. This institution has grown and continues to positively impact on the social and economic landscape of Dominica as we provide services to students and faculty.
Honorable Barron also reaffirmed the government's commitment to make land available at Warner for the expansion of the school. The Foreign Affairs Minister reminded students to maintain high ethical principles and to take the noble and humane profession of medicine seriously. 37 students received their white coats, while 18 students were awarded for making the Dean's Honor List at Saturday's ceremony. Coming up, your Creole highlights with McPherson St. Luce.
Hello, tout le monde. Bienvenue à ce nouvel en créole. Non, moi, c'est McPherson Saint-Louis. Premièrement, membre parlement pour constituency Maho, Honorable Ribbon Blackmore, qui a fait parole que Citizenship by Investment Program fait avec la $500,000 qui a dépensé pour réhabilitation chimie en constituency là. Honorable Blackmore mentionné travail en massacre.
Aussi, en place de que fromage et massacre. Donc, on a un chimie. Tout de suite, nous avons l'argent déjà. Nous avons mis un chimien dans une place où il y a un canal en massacre. Nous avons aussi le bâti sur un storm drain en formage de massacre. Nous avons aussi qu'à faire travail dans la place de la chimie. Nous avons mis un pont, nous avons bâti maçon, nous avons nettoyé la vie, la vie, aussi nous avons mangé la chimie. Puis là, Eric a passé, il a défoncé la chimie. Comme je parle en parlement, je fais certains nous manger ça. Nous avons dépensé plus l'argent là pour faire cette nuage ça.
À la nouvelle, ministère de Santé, honorable Dr. Kenneth Darrow, qui a fait parole que l'hôpital neuf qui pour bâti en Dominique, qui est bâti et puis standard international. Ministre Darrow fait parole sans là pendant groundbreaking cérémonie pour faciliter là qui prend place lundi. Aider l'hôpital Princess Margaret qui bâti en ses 50s là, bien servi Dominique. Et puis, tant là, oui, veut pour bâtir une facilité neuf. Selon ministre Darrow, facilité ça là qui want plusieurs services santé comme pédiatrique, gynécologie, et puis l'occasion pour banque ou la moun s'attaper traitement sans ailleurs. Traitement CT scan, radiologie, MRI, pathologie, et puis l'occasion, l'opération qui aussi là. Il y a l'occasion emergency et puis accident qui aussi tapé attention. L'occasion administrative, l'occasion pour Dr. Epinos, qui aussi tape attention. Plaisir d'autres l'occasion, car tape attention aussi. À la nouvelle, ça fait législation, harmonisation, bagaille quarantine pour pays OECS discuté pendant meeting quarantine qui prend place en Barbade. Chef département quarantine, Dominique Ran Ansem, représente Dominique en meeting cela.
C'est bien ça là, parce que bien important où j'attends nous parler contre free circulation of goods en OECS là où nous pouvons faire une commune législation avec one economic space en anglais ou qui est ça où les ni on harmonisation en commune législation là tout pays OECS là ni. Parce que ça est bien important pour nous travailler ensemble, pour nous garder comment nous ca pêcher, pas seulement maladie bête et plein, mais comment nous ca pêcher maladie affecter moun nous. So encore, nous ca travailler avec CARICOM, OECS, ICA, FAO, pour nous garder comment nous ca faire ces bagages là bien bon, pour porter plein, bête, moun, et environment là.
Et puis finalement, un programme Community Policing qui est lancé en village Calibichi Moissala. Parole Sala sorti au ministère de Sécurité Nationale, Honorable Ribbon Blackmore. Ministre Blackmore fait parole Sala pendant la présentation en Parlement, check de qui passe. Ministre a promoté le programme Sala, et spécialement en communauté rurale, bagaille qui est expecté pour baisser le crime en PA. North East PA a identifié pour chaîne au pilot programme pour le programme Sala. Honorable Blackmore dit que le gouvernement a tapé un plan action de police et puis aussi un commitment pour une meilleure relation entre eux et le public. Mais c'est mesdames, ça c'est tout pour nouvelle créole pour à présent. Non, moi c'est McPherson Saint-Louis. Au revoir.
Every day, police, fire, and ambulance vehicles respond to urgent calls. Any time lost getting to an emergency could mean the difference between life and death. As a driver, you can do your part to help save lives. Here's what to do on a two-lane road. Signal and move to the left. Pull as close as possible to the left edge of the road. Clear of any intersection and stop. That's all for this edition of National Focus. We always welcome your suggestions and comments. Drop us an email at gis@dominica.gov.dm or visit our website news.gov.dm. Like our Facebook page facebook.com/GIS News Dominica and follow our Twitter at GIS Dominica. You can also catch up on our past National Focus newscasts on our GIS Dominica YouTube channel. Live streaming is also available on our YouTube channel 24 hours a day. From all of us here on the GIS production team, I'm Lurian Graham Carter. Thanks for watching and join us again next time on National Focus.